Hi, I'm Shristi. So one of my favorite web hosts, Nodejitsu, are shutting down, and I have a heap of web apps that I need to find new homes for. Over the last few weeks, I've been looking into all of the different cloud hosts on the market, trying to find the right fit for some of the apps that I have. I'm looking for something that's really light touch and something that I don't need to worry about too much. And I stumbled across Azure. Well, I've heard about it before, but I haven't really used it myself up until sort of a few weeks ago. What was pretty cool is Azure have or Microsoft has a BizSpark program. So if you're like me, if you run a startup, you can actually get onto this program. It takes about a week or so to get approved for it. But once you're approved, you've got, I think it's like 2 or 3 years of access to a heap of Microsoft products, plus you get credit, a monthly credit to use for Azure. So that's really cool, because it means you can actually try out proper sort of production-based servers for your apps and actually use that as you're growing a startup, or even just like a side project idea. Okay, so I do have one of these accounts, and a few weeks ago I actually hosted an app up on Azure, and it actually has been fine in the time that it's been up, which has been pretty cool. So today I just wanted to just go through a really quick introduction to what Azure is all about and how you can host your Mean stack or any sort of node or any kind of web app really up on Azure. And this one is actually a really good host for someone who may not be all that comfortable or all that confident using the command line, because you can pretty much get everything up and running without using any command line, which is a little bit different to some of the other web hosts we've sort of looked at in the videos that I've covered so far. So without any further ado, let's jump in. So this is the one app that I've actually previously created, so there's not too much exciting going in here. I just need to jump down, click on the new button at the bottom. It sort of selects compute and web app for me, which is great because that's what I want. There's a couple of options you can use. You can do a quick create, which means that there's a couple of other options you have, but you can set them up later. Or you can go down the custom create, which is actually something that I'm going to do now, because it actually lets me set up my continuous deployment from source control. And what that means is that, say you're working on your project and you want to back it up, and you're using Git, and you want to push that through to your source control. So you might be using GitHub to save that, or you might be using Bitbucket or any of those kind of tools. What you can do here is hook straight into that, so you don't have to push code directly to Azure. You can just push it to GitHub or Bitbucket or any of those kind of things, and it will just suck it all up and make that available for you. So you'll just start off with a URL that's available. So I'm just gonna just see if that's available there. It's already defaulted my service plan, my subscription. I don't want a database. If you were using an SQL database, you can definitely select that for a Mean.js based product. I don't need one of those. And I'm going to choose this little checkbox down the bottom, which is publish from source control. Once I've done that, just click next. What that did do, by the way, it just added a second page here. So it means that when I hit the arrow, it's going to go across to the next page, which is cool. So you can then identify or tell this kind of wizard process where your source code is actually sitting. So even if it's on like Dropbox, you could even grab it direct from there, which is pretty cool. Mine's in Bitbucket, so I'm just going to tell it that that's where it is, and just click on the next button. This is going to authorize with Bitbucket. Now, because I have an app already, it has already got my details, and it's gone ahead and used those to authenticate. If you're doing this for the first time, you will have to obviously put in your username and password to make sure that your authentication works. I'm just going to select a repo name for the repo that I want. And that's pretty much it. So fingers crossed, and let's see how this goes. So the deployment process is actually fairly straightforward. Like there's only pretty much what we've just done. But so far, I've had a couple of issues with not everything quite working straight away. So I'm just going to see how we go. So it always makes me a little bit anxious when things happen so fast because it feels like something may have failed somewhere along the line, which is why it's so quick. So let's just have a look. I'm going to just have a quick look at the deployment information about the deployment, I should say. Okay, so it looks like it's still deploying. So it's probably set up the web app or the sort of the base place to put the app first, and now it's going through and actually grabbing everything it needs from Bitbucket. And hopefully deploying all of that code. Awesome. So once your deployment is complete, it should show up as active deployment. It should show some details of your last commit, whatever you did last. Okay, it seems to have an issue with .NET framework, which is really weird. Because it's Microsoft server. And it's installed all the valve packages. Okay, so it seems like the issue is this .NET bit. So let's see if I can do something about that. So it should have the most recent version. What I'm going to do is just restart it, see if there's just a problem with how it's been set up. Try that. Excellent. There we go. So that's my app. And it's up and running now. So it was a very quick and easy process. If you have an issue in the same way that I did, just try and restart and see if that fixes it for you. Look, I hope that helped. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Check out bossable.com for more details. Let me know the kind of things that you're working on at the moment, what kind of issues you're having or difficulties or things that are kind of slowing you down. And let's see if we can work through them together. I keep sharing my stories for the different things that I'm working on, and hopefully that helps you out as you're going through your app building situations too. All right, cool. We'll see you again soon.